Let's get this out of the way. You've probably heard that pee is sterile. It's not. Sorry, Bear Grylls. It's probably better not to drink your pee. But it wasn't just you who thought this. The whole medical field was pretty sure there weren't any bacteria down there for most of the last few centuries. It's only in the last few years that we've learned this isn't actually true. And that's a very good thing, as we're about to find out. Our bodies are home to trillions of bacteria, viruses, and fungi. This is our microbiome. The microbiome is crucial to our health. Bacteria in our gut help us digest food, microbes on our skin help keep infection at bay. There's even emerging evidence that organisms in our gut can help balance our mental health. Each part of our body has its unique microbial ecosystem. You expect to find different animals in the desert versus the ocean. In the same way, you'd expect to find a different community of organisms in different parts of the body. Like, only a few microbes will do well in your acidic stomach. Others will thrive in the nutrient goodness that is your mouth. But there are some exceptions. One bodily ecosystem thought to be totally microbeless was our urinary system. That's our kidneys, bladder, and the tubes that connect them all. This idea dates all the way back to Louis Pasteur in the 19th century, and it stuck around. Part of the reason is that until very recently, the only way to know what bacteria was present is by taking a swab and trying to grow whatever you'd picked up on a petri dish, what's called culturing the bacteria. Scientists who tried to grow bacteria from pee samples came up with zilch, so the medical field concluded that there was nothing to find. Well, almost everyone. A few rebels raised objections over the years, but when scientists launched a project to map the human microbiome in 2008, they decided not to include parts of the urinary system. Then genetic sequencing got way better, and all of a sudden, we could spot microbes just by picking up their DNA and RNA, and that meant finding ones we never knew existed in places we never expected. One of those places? Is pee. We now know that the urinary tract has its own ecosystem of bacteria. It's less diverse than other parts of the body, but it is there. And as we dig into it, we're learning that some of our least favorite urinary tract issues are directly related to its microbiome. But before we talk about that, it's time for a quick break to keep the lights on.
Thanks to Brilliant for supporting this SciShow video. Brilliant is an online learning platform that helps you build knowledge through interactive lessons. They're not sit-down lectures that you have to be in a specific place at a specific time to learn from. Brilliant makes it possible to learn anywhere as long as you have your phone, which, I mean, come on. When do you not have your phone? Whenever you have some spare minutes, you can dive into a new topic or do a quick practice session. And you can get the first 30 days free at brilliant.org/scishow, the QR code, or the link in the description. That link gives you 20% off an annual premium Brilliant subscription.
Now, pee issues might sound funny, but urinary tract disease is the 12th leading cause of death worldwide. And if you've ever had a urinary tract infection, you know they're no joke. So what does this have to do with the microbiome? Well, I need to introduce you to our two major players. First is E. coli. You've probably heard of this one. It's a fairly common and diverse bacterium. E. coli is a normal resident of our urinary tract, but sometimes they act up. This is the root cause of about 75% of UTIs. UTIs are nasty, they're painful, and worse, they can put you at risk for kidney stones. Around 150 million people get UTIs every year. But luckily, we have a microbe for that. Scientists have found that the urinary tract is also home to a group of bacteria called lactobacillus. These are another familiar group you might find in buttermilk and yogurt. Lactobacillus and E. coli seem to be caught up in a tug of war for the health of the urinary system. While E. coli is one of the main causes of UTIs, lactobacillus seems to ward off E. coli by making the urinary tract too acidic for the bacteria to thrive. There also seems to be an E. coli versus lactobacillus battle when it comes to kidney stones. Kidney stones are small crystals that form from substances in your urine. Around 10% of people will get kidney stones in their lifetime, and there's only one way for these painful little shards to get out of the body without surgery, and it's not a fun way. Passing a kidney stone is painful, and your first kidney stone increases your risk of getting more. That can set you up for kidney disease, which is bad, because you need your kidneys to pee. In a paper published in Nature Communications in 2024, researchers set up an experiment to try and recreate how the microbiome plays into kidney stone formation. They made artificial kidneys that swished artificial urine around. Then they added E. coli to some of those kidneys and lactobacillus to others. The artificial kidneys with E. coli in them made crystal-like structures, kind of like kidney stones, and those with lactobacillus made much smaller crystals, as if their formation was blocked. The researcher concluded that, just like with UTIs, lactobacillus must somehow help prevent E. coli from doing its nasty work. So a urinary microbiome that's rich in lactobacillus is probably better at fending off UTIs and kidney stones than one that isn't. Does that mean that drinking sour milk can help you avoid kidney stones? Unfortunately, it's probably not quite that easy. Urinary microbiome science is still very much in its infancy. infancy. We only just learned that it exists. So researchers are just starting to work out whether probiotics containing lactobacillus and the like can help with urinary tract issues. So far, the results are mixed. Recurring urinary tract infections can put people at greater risk of developing kidney stones. One small study showed that probiotics could help prevent recurring UTIs in perimenopausal women. And that's great, but so far, no one has been able to show that popping lactobacillus can help prevent UTIs in the first place. Similarly, there have been some attempts to use probiotics to deal with kidney stones, both in people and rodents. These are promising, but nowhere near being prescribed. That doesn't mean that this research isn't worth doing, though. The percentage of people every year who develop kidney stones has grown in recent decades. One possibility is that antibiotics are, at least partially, to blame. Early trials show that antibiotic overuse shifts the kidney microbiome of mice towards E. coli and away from lactobacillus. And antibiotics are currently the main way to treat urinary tract infections. They're also the standard use of care for many illnesses. And yet, using them too often might put people at risk of UTIs and kidney stones. That's good information that can help doctors make care decisions. The microbiome might also be involved with other urinary tract conditions. Scientists are starting to link what bacteria are swimming around our pee to things like bladder cancer and urinary incontinence. It's early days, but optimistic days too. So for now, you can probably expect to keep passing kidney stones the old-fashioned way, but there might come a time when doctors will prescribe some helpful bacteria to help you on the road to recovery.